I'm StudyOnion, and today we're going to be talking about the Earth's inner structure and atmosphere. Today, I'm going to cover the layout of the Earth's structure, as well as the benefits and drawbacks of the Earth's atmosphere, and a section about light pollution to finish. Let's get started!
So, let's take a look at some of the facts and the figures about the Earth.
The Earth has a mean diameter of 13,000 kilometres, and this makes it the largest of the terrestrial planets, which include Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. The shape of the Earth is known as an oblate spheroid, which basically means it looks like a slightly squashed
oval.
Water covers 70% of the Earth's surface. The Earth displays a vast array of beautiful features, from deserts to mountain ranges, volcanoes, glaciers, rainforests, and so on.
So, let us have a look at the Earth's internal divisions.
The Earth contains four major internal divisions: inner and outer core, mantle, and crust. Consists of giant tectonic plates that are floating and moving around on top of the mantle. The crust is the part that we stand on and has an average thickness of 50 kilometres.
There are two different types of crust:
continental and oceanic crust.
Older continental crust consists of low density rocks such as granite,
and the younger and thinner oceanic crust contains darker and denser rocks such as basalt. The most common elements in the crust are silicon and oxygen. After the crust comes the mantle. This is a silicate shell which has a thickness of around 2,900 kilometres, making up around 80% of the Earth's volume. The lower mantle, also known as the asthenosphere, is solid, whereas the upper mantle, or lithosphere, is semi-molten, which allows these convection currents to rise and fall, driving the motion of the tectonic plates.
The outer core is a liquid layer of iron and nickel. It is about 2,266 kilometres thick and has a temperature of around 5,000 Kelvin.
The charged particles which flow in here are responsible for the Earth's magnetic field, which protects us from the radiation that comes from the sun. The inner core, which is at temperatures of around 5,500 Kelvin, prevents the iron and nickel there from melting. Moving on to talk a little bit more about the atmosphere.
The Earth also beholds a rich atmosphere of nitrogen and oxygen, and most of the Earth's surface is actually covered by oceans of seawater. Now, let's have a little look at the benefits and also the drawbacks of the atmosphere.
The atmosphere has many, many benefits for us. Oxygen, which allows animals and plants to breathe. Carbon dioxide, allowing for photosynthesis. It makes the climate and temperature of the Earth consistent of a mean of around 15 degrees Celsius. It spreads out and scatters light from the sun, protects us from micrometeorite collisions in space, and protects us from the harmful UV radiation, or ultraviolet radiation, that comes from the sun. However, there are a few disadvantages of the atmosphere for astronomers. Firstly, scattering. The sky is blue, which limits observations to nighttime. Light from the sun is scattered by these nitrogen and oxygen particles in the atmosphere, and because most of this scattering occurs at these shorter wavelengths of blue and violet light, the sky is predominantly blue. The sky can also be red at sunset, and you might wonder why this is. This is because when the sun gets lower in the sky, the light emitted is travelling through more of the atmosphere before it can pass through and reach you. This means more of the blue light is scattered away, leaving only the yellow and red light left. Seeing. Air in the atmosphere is continuously rising and falling. Different densities of air rise and fall at different rates, causing the light to refract and change direction as it passes through many different layers. This makes the stars appear to twinkle. This is worse for stars lower near the horizon because the light must travel through more of the atmosphere. Seeing conditions can be measured using the Antonietti scale. Transmission. Many of the objects in space are only visible in parts of the EM spectrum that we cannot see. Ultraviolet and infrared, for example. The atmosphere absorbs many of these, and thus we cannot see them in our observations. Weather. The Earth's weather can block out our view of space, by clouds, for example. Light can also be scattered by dust storms and other weather patterns.
So, let's have a quick look at the cyanometer and the Antonietti scale.
So this shows the Antonietti scale, which is a scale used to measure seeing conditions, and the cyanometer is used to determine the blueness of the night sky. Another issue for astronomers is light pollution. Sky glow is the rusty orange haze cast by lights near urban cities, and local glare from sports grounds, supermarket car parks, street lights, and security lights that ruin the dark adaptation of their eyes.
Just to clarify, by dark adaptation, I refer to the rods in human eyes which become accustomed to the night sky and, as a consequence, allow us to distinguish and see with more clarity.
So, to quickly summarise for your notes, the Earth has a diameter of 13,000 kilometres, has the shape of an oblate spheroid. Water covers over 70% of the Earth's surface and displays a wide range of fantastic features. The Earth's internal divisions consist of the crust, mantle, inner core, and outer core, and consists of an atmosphere of nitrogen and oxygen. The benefits of the atmosphere include oxygen to breathe, absorbing most of the UV and X-ray radiation, regulating temperature, and protecting us from most meteoroids. The drawbacks include scattering, adverse seeing conditions, transmissions, and weather. There is also two types of light pollution, sky glow and local glare. Hopefully that helped you learn more about GCSE astronomy, this topic, specifically planet Earth, and you're excited for next time. See you guys! Bye!